They are Florida doctors hired by the state to identify child abuse.
And while they're praised for saving countless lives, what happens when these doctors get it wrong?
Contact 5 investigator Katie Legrone spoke with a handful of Florida families who say they were torn apart when the diagnosis proved to be something else.
You want to make a cube.
For Viviana and Jeremy Graham, life revolves around 4-year-old Tristan. But 4 months into their adventure as a family, this trio was torn apart.
Call 911, Tristan's having a seizure, and I see him holding Tristan. Tristan's seizing.
Doctors determined Tristan had a brain bleed, and a child abuse pediatrician knew why. Physical abuse, specifically abusive head trauma, such as violent shaking injury, according to court records provided to us by the parents.
He was seen by so many different doctors before we took him again to the hospital the second time. So to us, we were like, what is going on?
Child abuse pediatricians are specially trained to spot child abuse. There are 22 in Florida who work as experts across the state. It's an industry where records are kept private to protect children. And while their opinions can save thousands of lives each year, court records now reveal they can also tear families apart when conclusions implicate parents who seem to have done everything right.
We sort of got ambushed, we felt like.
Once the state pediatrician called it abuse, Tristan was removed from home, Jeremy arrested for aggravated child abuse. A West Coast, Florida firefighter and paramedic, his mug made headlines.
I didn't know if I was ever going to get him back.
The Grahams are among a small but vocal group of Florida parents.
It's like losing everything.
Now speaking out about a system they say doesn't always get it right.
So I said, we didn't do anything. She said, no, yes, you guys did. Wow.
Last summer, Vadim Kushner and his wife also found themselves on the defense after seeking help. A state child abuse pediatrician determined their newborn seizures were the result of shaken baby or blunt force trauma.
They took our kids.
The Kushners fought back, spending $30,000 on attorneys and experts who argued the baby's condition resulted from a complicated birth, not abuse. The judge agreed, criticizing the state's doctors for not knowing the month-old baby wasn't breathing at birth, the umbilical cord wrapped tightly around his neck. One admitted he never reviewed all the baby's medical records.
We do everything we can to make sure we make the appropriate diagnosis.
Dr. Suzanne Haney leads a National Pediatric Child Abuse Council. She's not involved in any of the Florida cases, but says these experts are extensively trained. Studies show they're less likely than other doctors to diagnose abuse.
Because we do understand all of the possible, mimics and other misdiagnoses that can happen.
She says abuse has to be diagnosed by a team, not just the expert who should know the child's full medical history and interview the parents directly.
The parents don't know why.
Attorney Jordan Abramowitz says that doesn't always happen.
The procedure of how they commence their cases is flawed.
Last year, he represented this young South Florida family, torn apart when the state pediatrician concluded abuse caused 22 fractures and bruises on their newborn.
All I could think of was
Grandma Nydia Ortiz.
This is a mistake. This is going to be corrected. It's not right.
The child's pediatric records were not reviewed before the termination was made. The parents were not interviewed. Their medical history wasn't taken.
Had that happened, Abramowitz claims they would have learned these parents spent weeks at doctor's offices over concerns about bruise marks. One even suspected the baby had a rare genetic disorder. Turns out she did.
In criminal trials, you're innocent to proven guilty, but child abuse cases, it felt like the burden fell on us. That was the most surprising.
8 months after the state removed Tristan from his parents, it dropped its case. Insufficient evidence.
I'll never forgive and forget.
I want her to remember that she didn't break us.
Every year, Viviana sends the state pediatrician a holiday card. 2 years ago, the doctor wrote back.
I try very hard to be thorough and get it right, but perhaps I need to be more careful to consider gray areas.
This is Nydia's son in May, moments after a judge ruled there was no child abuse and criticized the state's doctors for not interviewing the parents to assess their medical histories. This young family reunited immediately.
It was a nightmare.
It took 7 months and this grandmother's life savings.
$130,000.
How many cases are out there where the parents don't have money, didn't have the ability to get the right expert to see what's going on, and the parents lose their children?
For weeks, we've asked the State Department of Health for answers. They've refused our interview requests, haven't fulfilled our public records requests. Last week, I sent them a list of questions. Still no response. Meantime, these families want change, a new law that would require child abuse pediatricians interview parents directly, and in some cases, get a second opinion before a child is removed from their parents. Katie Legrone, WPTV News, Channel 5.